Marvin Gaye Jr. was born in Washington, D.C. on April 2, 1939. His father, Marvin Gaye Sr., and mother, Alberta Gaye, raised him along with two siblings. Gaye had an abusive relationship with his father that went on throughout not only his childhood, but his entire life. Gaye dropped out of high school and joined the Air Force in order to escape the beatings he endured at home. After telling officers that he had a mental illness, he was honorably discharged in 1957. He then began to pursue his singing career. Gaye joined a group with his friend Reese Palmer called the Marquise, but by 1960 the group broke up. After dabbling with groups and different labels, Gaye went solo and produced many top 50 Billboard songs. The first song that landed number one on the top 100 Billboard was I Heard It Through the Grapevine. Then in 1971, he released a song called What's Going On. The song was believed to be too political to be on radio, but being inspired from an event by police brutality, Gaye wrote the song. Gaye went on strike from producing music until The Label was released. The label was then eventually released and ended up selling over 2 million copies.
Mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some.
Here's a look on how Marvin Gaye talks about his writing.
Well, I don't know how many phases my music's gone through. I write my music according to my lifestyle. If I'm sad, I write sad music. If I'm being divorced, I write divorce albums. If I'm sexy, if I feel hot and no horny as I'm not right away, yeah.
After becoming well-known throughout the music industry, the album Let's Get It On dropped in 1973, in which it took off the career and truly made Marvin Gaye an icon. Marvin Gaye was a truly gifted songwriter and musician. Over the next decade, Gaye made countless hits including Distant Lover, I Want You, and Got to Give It Up. But in the midst of his fame, he battled with severe depression and a cocaine addiction. In the early 80s, he moved back in with his parents to help him get his life back on track. On April 1st, 1984, Marvin and his father got in a heated argument. Marvin Gaye Sr. shot his son in the head. Marvin Gaye was killed by his father hours before his 45th birthday. On April 5th, over 10,000 people came to mourn at the funeral of Gaye. Gaye left behind 3 children. He also left behind countless hits and left an incredible mark on the music industry. Though Gaye had countless hits, he only won 1 Grammy, and it was for the song Sexual Healing in 1982.
Just like you love me, I need to love me, yeah. Baby,
Early in Gaye's career, he performed with a woman named Tammy Terrell. They made a number of hit songs, but their most popular was Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Marvin Gaye was often referred to as the Prince of Soul, who will be remembered by his great smile, wonderful music, and the mark he made on society as a whole.